we proceed to the nature of long-term objective. Okay, when we talk about objective, you come up with two types, which is a financial objective and a strategic objective. Long-term objective represent the result expected from pursuing certain objective. So here we have a two type of objective. If any company you establish, you must have objective. So here this chapter is come up with two type of objective, which is a financial objective and a strategic objective. Financial objective is include associated with a growth, its revenue, growth in earning, higher dividends, large profit margin, a greater return on investment, and higher earning per share. It means that of any is a profit, and any of the number is a focus of the financial objective. A second is a strategic objective. Strategic objective is include a thing such as a large market share, quicker on time delivery than rivals, shorter design to market times than rival, and lower cost than rivals. So before one of company is establish their objective, so here have the characteristic of objective. So today we have eight characteristic of objective. It's the quantitative, measurable, realistic, understandable, challenging, hierarchical, obtainable, and congruent. So if any company want decide their objective, they must follow the characteristic. Quantitative mean measure by quantitative. It mean it's more focused about the target, sales, and amount. The second characteristic of objective is measurable. It mean that a timeline to keep track, which mean that the company has their timeline to keep track the objective. The third is realistic, which mean that possible to achieve. If any objective they decide, the objective must have realistic and possible to achieve. The next characteristic is understandable, mean keep the simple. The objective must be understandable and simple and easy to their staff to understand the objective. And next is challenging, that the objective must be challenging. The next is hierarchical, obtainable, which means that it's achievable and can to achieve. And the last characteristic of objective is congruent, which means that align cross department.
Okay, next I will proceed to benefits of having clear objective. The first one is provide direction by revealing expectation. By having a clear objective, the employees will know what are the expectations of the company from them. The next one is allow synergy, which is the combination of idea. The third one is aid in evaluation by serving as standard. The objective will be the standard objective for all to achieve. Next is establish priorities. So the employees will know what are the priority in the company. Next is reduce uncertainty. Because we know what we want, so we will reduce the uncertainty, and we know what we need to do and to achieve. Next is minimize conflict, and then stimulate assertions, which is the spirit to do it. Next is aid in allocation of resource, and then aid in design of job, means the work that we have to do. And lastly is provide basis for consistent decision making. Okay, now we move to the not managing by objective. So there are four types of not managing by objective. The first one is managing by extrapolation, managing by crisis, managing by subjective, and managing by hope. Meaning of managing by extrapolation is they adhere the principle, if it in broke, don't fix it. That means As long as there is no problem, they will not change the objective. Managing by crisis. So managing by crisis, they will react but no action taken. And then managing by subjective. Build on the idea that there is no general plan for which way to go and what to do. Just do the best you can to accomplish what you think should be done. Which means that the managing by subjective is not clear, not having clear objective. And lastly is managing by hope, based on the fact that the future is laden and planning with great uncertainty, and that if we try and do not succeed, then we hope our second or third attempt will succeed. So managing by hope is something that they will try and error, If they will not succeed with one objective, then they will try another attempt. Next, we move to balance scorecard. Balance scorecard is a strategic evaluation and control technique. So basically, the balance scorecard is measurement tools to measure the performance. Previously, we used ISO, KPI. So these are the tools to measure the performance. So balance scorecard cover four areas, which are customer, managers, employees, operation, process, community, and social responsibility. So an effective balance scorecard contains a carefully chosen combination of strategy and financial objective. They lead to the company's business. The overall aim is to balance shareholder objective with customer and operational objective.
There are four types of strategy, which are integration strategy, intensive strategy, diversification strategy, and defensive strategy. First is integration strategy. There are three types: forward integration, backward integration, and horizontal. For forward integration, it means that it involves gaining ownership of increased control over distributor. It means that the company take control over their distributor. For example, Proton bought Proton Ada. Next. Okay, the guidelines is when the present distributor are expensive or unreliable, when the availability of quality distributor is so limited, and when the present distributor have high profit margin. Next is backward integration. It's a strategy seeking of ownership and increased control over a firm's supplier. It means that the company take control over their supplier. For example, instead of buying chicken from farm A, KFC bought and owned the whole farm. Okay, the guidelines is when the present supplier are expensive or unreliable, when the number of supplier are small and number of competitor are large, and lastly, when an organization needs to quickly acquire a needed resources. The last strategy is horizontal integration. This means that a strategy seeking of ownership and increased control over a firm competitors. For example, Nokia was taken over by Microsoft because Nokia cannot bear their loss. For horizontal integration guidelines, first is when an organization compete with in a growing company, when increased economy of scale provide major competitive advantage, and lastly, when organization has both capital and human talent needed to successfully manage an expanded organization.
Okay, now I will continue with the intensive strategies. There are intensive strategy. There are three strategies, which is market penetration, market development, and product development. For market penetration, it seeking increase a market share for the present product or services in present market through greater marketing efforts. This market penetration needs marketing effort to sell their product. For example, Coca-Cola Christmas advert, which has helped boost sales during the festive period. Next, for the guideline, for the penetration, market penetration is when current market are not saturated with particular product or services, when the usage rate of present customer could be increased significantly, and the last one is when the market share of major competitor have been declining, but total industry sales have been increasing. Next is market development. For market development, it wants to introduce the new product or service in a new geographic area. Such as Ford Motor is introducing 8 new vehicles in India between 2011 until 2015 to capitalize on increasing demand in the fast expanding car market. For the guideline is when the new channel of distribution are available in a new that reliable in expensive and quality. The next is when an organization is very successful at what it does. When new untapped or unsaturated market exit, and the last one is when an organization has excess production capacity. The last one is product development. It want to increase the sales by improving the present product or services or developing new ones. Such as Apple introduced new iPhone, such from iPhone 4 to iPhone 5 to iPhone 6 and so on. For the guideline is when organization has successful product that are in a maturity stage of the product life life cycle. The idea here is to attract satisfied customer to try new product in their company as a result to their positive experience with the organization present product or services. When an organization compete in an industry such as iPhone compete with the Samsung, Vivo, Lenovo and so on. The last one is when major competitor offer better quality product at comparable price.
Now we proceed to the diversification strategies. When we talk about diversification, it's come up with two types, which means related diversification strategies and unrelated diversification strategies. Okay, related diversification is a value change process competitively valuable cross-business strategic fits. So in order to use a related diversification, they have their own guidelines. So the guideline of the related diversification is when an organization competes in a no-growth or a slow-growth industry, when adding new but related product would significantly enhance the sale of current products, and when new but related product could be offered at highly competitive price, and when an organization has a strong management team. Now we proceed to the unrelated diversification. Okay, unrelated means value chains are so dissimilar that not competitively valuable cross-business relationship exists. Okay, when the company use unrelated, also they have a guideline, same with the related. So the unrelated guideline is when revenues derived from an organization current product would increase significantly by adding the new unrelated product. When an organization present channels of distribution can be used to make to market the new product to current customer, and when an organization basic industry is experiencing declining annual sales and a profit. So this is a guideline if the company want make unrelated diversification.
Okay, now I proceed with the defensive strategies. The defensive strategies is a strategy to defend the company from going bankrupt. So there are three defensive strategy, which is retrenchment, divestiture, and the last one is liquidation. The first one is retrenchment. It is occurs when an organization regroups through cost and asset reduction to reverse declining sales and profit. This is when they reduce the size of the organization. Or for example, they fired a few of their employees. This is to make sure that they are good financially. It is also called as turnaround or reorganizational strategy designed to fortify an organization's basic distinctive competence and can entail selling off land and building. The next one is the guideline of the retrenchment. The guideline of the retrenchment is when an organization has a clearly distinctive and second distinctive competence but has failed consistently to meet its objective and goals over time. When they can achieve their goals, so they do the retrenchment. The next guideline is when an organization is one of the weaker competitors in a given industry, when the company could not compete in the industry with the other competitors. The last guideline is when an organization has grown so large so quickly that major internal reorganization is needed. The next strategy is divestiture. This strategy is when the company sell part of their organization. For example, Sam Darby Plantation sold the Sam Darby property. It is used to raise capital for further strategic acquisitions or investments.
release unprofitable business diversity, become less diversified. The guideline is when organization has pursued a retrenchment strategy and failed to accomplish needed improvement. When they do the retrenchment strategy and fail doing that strategy, they will proceed with the divestiture strategies. And the next guideline is when a division needs more resources to be competitive than the company can provide. The last guideline is when a division is responsible for an organization's overall poor performance. When the company have poor performance, so they need to sell off one of the part of the organization. So the last strategy is liquidation. This is where the company selling all of company's asset for their tangible worth. Recognition of defeat and consequently can be an emotional difficult strategy. This is when they sold the whole organization. The guidelines for liquidation is when an organization has pursued both retrenchment strategy and a divestiture strategy and neither has been successful. When both of the strategy could not be successful, they will proceed with liquidation, which is sell off all of the organization or all the assets of the company. The next guideline is when an organization's only alternative is bankruptcy, when the company could not get any profit anymore, so they need to sell the company. The last guidelines that I would tell you is when the stockholders of a firm can minimize their losses by selling the organization's assets. So this is their last decision that they need to do if they could not find any alternative to help the company.
Okay, I will continue with the Michael Porter generic strategy. They are consist of three: cost leadership, differentiation, and focus. Inside the Michael Porter generic consists of five types. First, cost leadership emphasize producing standardized product at a lower per unit cost for consumers who are price sensitive. Example, cost leadership a firm try to reduce the price and cost of product and service. Inside a cost leadership consists of two types, type 1 and type 2. As for type 1, low cost strategy that offer product or service to a wide range of consumer at a lower price available on the market. Example like MyDin and EconSafe. Type 2, a best value strategy that offer product or service to a wide range of customer, a range of product or service at a lower price available compared to a rival product with a similar attribute. The best value means the firm pick a certain time to sell their product at a lower price. For the cost leadership, they have two ways: perform value chain activities more efficiently than a rival, and control the factor that drive the cost of value chain activities. Second is revamp the firm's overall value chain to eliminate or bypass some cost producing activities. There are some effective conditions of cost leadership strategies. When price competition among rival sellers is especially vigorous, example Euro Mineral and Texas have the same taste and price. When there are few ways to achieve product differentiation, then have a value to buyer. When buyer use the product in the same way. When buyer incur low cost in switching their purchase from one seller to another. Example like one customer buy mineral water at EconSafe, they also get the same product at Tesco. When a buyer are large and have a significant power to bargain down the price, they can find another alternative that offer them a lower price. Next, the insight differentiation, they consist of type 3. Type 3 is mean by unique product. strategy aimed at producing product and service considered unique, industry-wide and directed at customers who are relatively price sensitive. Example, EcoWorld and IGM Land. EcoWorld is using Green Go, and IGM Land using a standard method. So there are different. EcoWorld try to become a unique company other than IGM Land. They are using the standard plan. Next, there are effective of differentiation strategies. When there are many ways to differentiate the product or service, and many buyers perceive this difference as having value. As for customer, they are searching for a different type of product that they can get from a seller. When buyer needs and use are diverse, when our rival firm are following similar differentiation approach. When technology change is fast paced and competition revolve around rapidly evolving product features. Next, third, lastly is a focus. Focus means producing product and service that fulfill the needs of small group of consumer. Example, luxury product. Other than that, focus means by one company producing their product, and they are focused on hire people income to buy their product. So they are focusing on the luxury product. Inside their focus consists of two types, type 4 and type 5. Type 4 offer product or service to a niche group at lower price. Example like Maxwell Electronic offering and Lenovo Electronic offering. These two product is offering a customer at a lower price. So they are focusing on a low middle income customer. For type 5, offer product and services to a niche group at a higher price but loaded with features, so the offering are perceived at the best value. Example like Bentley automobile and Apple smartphone. This type of company is focusing on a higher income level, and they are offer a product that consists of a many features and benefit, and that's suitable with the price. Effective condition of focus strategy. When the target market niche is large, profitable and growing. When industry leader do not consider the niche to be crucial to their own success. When industry leader consider it too costly and difficult to meet the specialized needs of the target market niche while taking care of their mainstream customer.
Means for achieving strategy. It has four ways to achieving strategy. Firstly is cooperation among competitors, joint venture, merger and acquisition, private equity acquisition, first mover advantage and outsourcing. Firstly is cooperation among competitors. For collaboration between competitors to succeed, what firm contributes something distinctive, for example technology or basic research. A major risk is that unintended transfers of important skills or technologies may occur at organizational level below. Next is joint venture or partnering. It means two or more companies form a temporary partnership for the purpose of capitalizing some opportunity, for example, Nokia Corporation and Microsoft. The common problem that caused joint venture to fail, first is the manager who must collaborate daily in operating the venture are not involved in forming or shaping the venture. Second, the venture may not be supported equally by both partner. And lastly, the venture may begin to compete more with one of the partners than the others. The guideline for effective means for pursuing strategy. First, when the distinct competitors of two or more firms complement each other especially well. Second, when some project is potentially very profitable but require overwhelming resources and risk. Next, when two or more smaller firms have trouble competing with large firms. And lastly, when there exists a need to quickly introduce a new technology. Next, for merger and acquisition. A merger occurs when two organizations of about equal size unite to form one organization. Acquisition means a large organization purchases a smaller firm or vice versa. Key reason why many mergers and acquisitions to fail: first, too much diversification; second, large or extraordinary debt; third, too large an acquisition; and lastly, inability to achieve synergy. The potential benefit of merging with or acquiring another firm: first, to gain new technology; second, to reduce managerial staff; third, to reduce tax obligation; and lastly, to gain economic of scale.
I will continue with a first mover advantage. Refer to the benefit a firm may achieve by entering a new market or developing a new product or service prior to arrival firm. For example, on 1980, A&W is the first mover or a fast food that entered Malaysia. However, in 1990s, McDonald's entered to Malaysia and makes the market share of A&W are declining. So, there's a benefit of a company that become a first mover in a certain country. Secure access and commitment to rare resources. They are easy to get their supplier because they are the first producing the product. Second is gain new knowledge of critical success factor and issue. Third is gain market and position in the best location. They can choose their location because they are the first. For outsourcing and reshoring, business process outsourcing and involve company hiring other company to take over various part of their functional operation, such as HR, information system, payroll, accounting, and etc. Reshoring is the new term that refer to US company planning to move some of their manufacturer back to the US. Example, like one company is outsourcing their one department, example like HR department, to another company to do their work. So this mean by outsourcing, hire someone to complete our job and task. So the benefit of outsourcing is a cost saving, access lower wages in a foreign country. This is the common benefit that they the company get when they are outsourcing, because mostly a company outsource their functional operation to a country that have a low range of wages. Example like Bangladesh and Indonesia. Second is focus on core business. Focus on resources on developing the core business rather than being distracted by other function. Focus on core business. So the company can focus on the main business activities other than think about the other functional operation, because this is the benefit for them to become a focus and to become a greater. Third is knowledge, gain access to intellectual property and wider experience and knowledge. Thank you.
Okay, we continue with the strategic management in non-profit and governmental organizations. It consists in four, which is religious facilities, educational institution, medical organization and governmental agency and departments. I will focus on two, which is religious facilities and educational institution. For religious facilities, a recent Wall Street Journal article revealed that the number of facilities having to close their door is surging as many borrow too much and too big during boom time. This is like religious facilities is important for us, but the existence of religious facilities is not to get the profit. They just want to accommodate the people in their place. Like businesses, in many ways, including daycare, foreclose, open if their finances fall into this array, and they need effective strategic planning to make religious facilities more convenient for the other person. Next is educational institution. For educational institution, frequently it uses strategic management technique and concept to be the top to compete with each of the university. For example, UITM will compete to be the top ranking compared to the University of Malaysia and others. USL, UPM, UKM, and UM. Many American colleges and universities have not established campus outside the United States.
So, next one is medical organizations. The medical organizations is, for example, hospitals creating new strategies today as advances in the diagnosis and treatment of chronic disease are undercutting that earlier mission. In the beginning, hospitals are to bring services to the patient. That is what hospitals are for us. A successful hospital strategy for the future will require renewed and deepened collaboration with physicians, central to hospitals' well-being, and a reallocation of resources. So as time goes by, the hospital has become more advanced, so they came up with a strategy where they require renewed and deepened collaboration with the physicians to make the hospital becomes better. So the current strategy is include creating home health services, establishing nursing homes, and forming rehabilitation centers. They created a lot of other services instead of just cure the patient. Backward integration strategies include acquiring ambulance services, waste disposal services, and diagnostic services. The next one is governmental agencies and departments. For example, the police and the firemen's departments. Federal, state, county, and municipal agencies and departments are responsible for formulating, implementing, and evaluating strategies that use taxpayers' dollars to provide services and programs. So they use taxpayers to provide services such as the police help the any victims that are in any problems. So it operate with less strategy autonomy than their counterparts in private firms. Legislators and politicians often have direct or indirect control over major decisions and resources. Issues become politicized. Most of the governmental agencies and departments becomes politicized, resulting in fewer strategic choice alternatives. The government agencies are using a strategic management approach to develop and substantiate formal requests for additional funding. So the governmental agencies and departments can be used as the funding to help people that are in need. The last one is the strategic management in small firms. Strategic management is important in small firms or in the big firms. So the strategic management process is just as important for small companies. So all organizations have a strategy, even if the strategy is evolved from day to day operation. So the strategic management is important in any organization. Even though we are small firm, we also need strategy management process because every organization needs to have the strategy management to proceed with their daily operations. That's all from me.